The weekend of April 20th through the 22nd, 2006, was a wonderful, exciting weekend for Mom and Dad. It was filled with many memories and stories of victories gained and friends long forgotten. It was the first time Dad had returned to Memorial Stadium, and it was the 60th anniversary of his victory in the 2-mile relay in the 1946 Kansas Relays. The icing on the cake was Dad's enshrinement in the Booth Family Hall of Athletics at KU. The Sigma Chi House, as beautiful today as ever, it is the finest house on the KU campus, just as it was in 1946. Bob and Nancy Laptad. Bob is a loyal Sigma Chi, an ex-Marine, a great distance runner, and one of our parents' oldest and dearest friends. Bob was best man at Mom and Dad's wedding. Unfortunately, Bob and Dad are the only known survivors of the great 1946 team. Mom and Wes Santee. Wes, arguably the greatest of all American distance runners, a world record holder at KU. In 1954, Wes ran the 3 fastest miles ever run and was battling Roger Bannister of Great Britain for the honor of being the first man ever to break the 4-minute mile. Although Bannister broke it first, Wes will always be a hero at KU. The Kansas Experience is the theme of the Booth Family Hall of Athletics. This impressive facility contains many displays showing the history of KU athletics. The track and field section will house displays for the Kansas Relays, as well as those KU conference champions who made Bill Easton the greatest of all American track coaches. By 1866, the University of Kansas at Lawrence had adopted the mythical bird, the Jayhawk, as a part of the famous KU yell, Rock Chalk. Also on display in the Hall of Athletics at KU is a database which shows the history of all KU lettermen. On this slide, you see Dad's record at the University of Kansas. Here is the assistant director of the Kansas Relays addressing the men being honored. Here is Dad and some of the other honorees as they prepare for the dedication ceremony to begin. Tom Keegan, the sports editor for the Lawrence Journal World, interviews honorees as they prepare to cut the ribbon for the dedication ceremony. This bronze plaque honors all Kansas champions that ran for Bill Easton, the greatest of all American track coaches. Dad's name is the first on the list. The honorees gather at the alumni tent to prepare for their on-field introduction instructions. It's at this time that they learn that they will be called the legends of the Kansas Relays. A reporter on the field asked Dad, "What does it feel like to be called a legend?" Dad laughed and said, "I've been called a lot of names in my day, but legend certainly is not one of them." Dad said this was the most unexpected and biggest surprise of his life. It was unbelievable that after 60 years, he found himself and Bob Laptad on the victory stand at Memorial Stadium again with the greatest runners in KU history being honored in front of Mom and 26,000 cheering fans. It is a moment he will never forget. Mom enjoys the view from the alumni section. The relays are about to begin. The honor guard plays the national anthem, and a marching acrobatic team from Kansas City opens the ceremonies. The 2006 Kansas Relays were the 79th edition of this track and field classic. During the three-day meet, over 620 teams, 5,300 high school, college, and Olympic-level athletes filled the University of Kansas Memorial Stadium with track and field athletes and fans. Sixty years later, the Jackson name appears again in victory at the Kansas Relays, as a young man wins the boys' 110-meter high hurdles in 14:48. Mom and University of Kansas Chancellor Bob Hemenway. Mom is smiling because Chancellor Hemenway has just told her that he is writing a book and wants to include Dad in it. Of course, Mom makes sure Dad agrees. Here is Mom and Bob Laptad enjoying the relays from high above the track at Memorial Stadium in Chancellor Hemenway's beautiful suite. It is a spectacular view, but what you can't see up close you can watch on TV and enjoy. Here is the start of the 400 meter race. The perfect weekend concluded with another memorable event. The Hall of Fame banquet concluded the activities of the Kansas Relay weekend and the dedication that Mom and Dad enjoyed so much. Here again with Bob and Nancy Laptad, they enjoyed a fantastic conclusion to an outstanding, memorable weekend. The first Kansas Relays took place in the then-new Memorial Stadium in 1923. The early years featured such great athletes as Tom Poor, Jim Bausch, and Glenn Cunningham of Kansas, Ed Weir of Nebraska, Jack Elder of Notre Dame, and Tom Churchill of Oklahoma. Equally impressive was the list of meet referees, including the inventor of basketball, Dr. James Naismith, KU basketball All-American Adolph Rupp, and Notre Dame football coach Newt Rockne. By the late 1940s, Coach Bill Easton's crew was an all-star meet all by itself, dominating the Kansas Relays and the entire relay circuit. Athletes like Dad, Wes Santee, Al Order, and Billy Mills drew huge crowds to the KU campus and attracted top competition from around the nation. When Bob Timmons took over the reins of the Jayhawk program in the 1960s, the team didn't miss a beat. Jim Ryan won three consecutive Outstanding Athlete Awards as the Kansas Relays in 1966, 67, and 68 for a Kansas Relays best. The 1970s saw the world's top sprinters come to the Kansas Relays, as Missouri standout Mel Gray won three university titles in the 100-yard dash, and in the open 100-yard dash, Olympians John Carlos, Herb Washington, and Ivory Crockett each took titles in the early 70s. Bruce Jenner, the familiar competitor from Grayson College, who later gained fame as the 1976 Olympic gold medalist decathlete, was the 1971 titleist as a collegian, and also won the 1974 crown.